The Bing Crosby Show. This is Ken Carpenter welcoming you to the Bing Crosby Show, presented by the people of General Electric. Produced and transcribed in Hollywood with John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, and Bing's guests, the Four Aces. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Bing.
The whole town's talking about the Jones boy, the Jones boy, the Jones boy. The whole town's talking about the Jones boy. He acts mighty peculiar now. The whole town's saying he was a good boy, a nice boy, a swell boy. The whole town thinks that he's not a well boy. He just isn't the same somehow. He hops, he jumps so merrily over the water pumps. He stops and then he'll come to a pump and he'll jump again. They're buzzing over the fences. The kid's gone out of his senses. The whole town's talking about the Jones boy, that poor boy, the Jones boy. But I just happen to know the Jones boy, and he happens to be in love. Yes, he happens to be in love. He jumps so merrily over the water pumps. He stops and then he'll come to a pump and he'll jump again. They're buzzing over the fences. The kid's gone out of his senses. The whole town's talking about the Jones boy, that poor boy, the Jones boy. But I just happen to know the Jones boy, and he happens to be in love. Yes, he happens to be in love.
Very nice, Bill.
Thank you, Ken. Yes, sir, the whole town's talking about the Jones boy. Thanks to the Mills brothers.
Right, you are. by the way, let's not overlook that other lad. The whole town's talking about that Hope boy, too.
No kidding. Yeah. What happened? Hope get caught with a gunny sack full of hot parakeets? Or is he nabbed in the act of repainting his 1953 license plates? Or has he stooped to stealing Jaguar hubcaps? Is that it? What is going on later?
No, nothing like that, Bing. Everybody's talking about Bob because his life story is now running in the Saturday Evening Post.
Oh, it's a shameless admission, isn't it?
Most interesting, too. You following it?
Like the Japanese movie fans are following Marilyn Monroe.
Don't get trampled to death. But to get back to Bob, Bing.
Do we have to?
He'd appreciate it.
Well, if it makes the boy happy.
You know, Bing, Bob's story in the Post is going to run for 9 issues.
9 issues, huh? Now, there must be a catty joke in here, but I can't figure out where.
That's right, though, Bing. Bob's story is going to run for 9 weeks. Your story only ran for 8 weeks in the Post.
Well, he's more interesting than I am. Let me tell you something else, Ken. Hope's story would have run for 900 issues if they hadn't have stopped.
I don't think Bob is so gabby in his private life, Bing. I'd say that Bob is kind of an introvert, sort of in his shell.
Yeah, like an oyster that's turned playboy, he's in his shell.
You want to know?
I'm an authority on bivalves.
I thought Hope was of English descent.
I don't think we have time to explore that, Ken. The only thing about Hope's story that burns me up, it really steams me, this bugs me good, is the title.
Well, I think it's a good title. This is on me. What's wrong with that?
Well, I think that a fellow who's never bought a drink for anybody in his life's got a lot of crust to call his story, This Is On Me.
Bing, how about those old vaudeville pictures of Hope? Only skinny, regular string bean.
Boy, he's an eggplant now.
Or perhaps a cassava melon?
Crenshaw, maybe. Sometimes he looks rather Hubbard squashish to me. But more of Hope's thrilling life another time, Ken. I feel the need now to go along with a nice waltz, Changing Partners. This is a song which I recorded not too long ago for Decca.
To a dreamy melody, when they called out, "Change partners," and you waltzed away from me. Now my arms feel so empty as I gaze around the floor, and I'll keep on changing partners till I hold you once more. Though we dance for one moment, and too soon we had to part, in that wonderful moment something happened to my heart. So I'll keep changing partners till you're in my arms, and then, oh my darling, I will never change partners again. Oh, we danced for one moment, and too soon had to part. In that wonderful moment, something happened to my heart. So I'll keep changing partners till you're in my arms, and then, oh my darling, I will never change partners again. Oh, my darling, I will never change partners again.
Thank you, folks. Guest time now, ladies and gentlemen, and we're very happy to present a quartet which we've imported from the Thunderbird up in Las Vegas. This foursome, Al Alberts, Dave Mahoney, Saad Vaccaro, and Lou Silvestri, are better known and, well, certainly well known to you all as the Four Aces. Take a bow, boys. Hey, Al, what are you strangers in paradise going to serenade us with tonight, huh?
Well, if it's all right with you, Bing, we'd like to do a song which Decca Records is going to release on us next week. A real wonderful old-timer called So Long.
Oh, I remember it well. It's a great tune. I'm with the Decca Company, too, you know. I'm a label licker over there. Well, you got the stage, fellas, the microphones, the orchestra, go.
So long, hope we'll meet again someday. Hope that maybe then you'll say, darling, I was wrong. So long. Gee, I hate to see you go. You're the world to me, you know. You've been mine so long. All alone, with my memories of you, I can dream that you're lonely too. You're my own, even though we're far apart, I will keep you right here in my heart. So long,
though you leave me here to cry,
It can never be goodbye. We'll just say so long. So long, so long. Hope we'll meet again someday, someday. Hope that maybe then you'll say, you'll say, darling, I was wrong. So long, so long. Though you leave me here to cry, to cry, it can never be goodbye, goodbye. We'll part and say so long.
Very fine, man. That's a beauty. Wonderful. I'll have a big sale. What have you got for us now?
Well, Bing, how about you running through another great old time? Remember Heart of My Heart?
I've just been sitting here, just gumming my nails, hoping you'd ask me, and I accept the invitation.
But you know what, Bing? Now we've got five aces.
Sure, not here in the West. Whenever there's five aces, somebody gets shot. I have a feeling it's going to be me.
Heart of my heart, I love that melody. Heart of my heart, brings back a memory.
When we were kids on the corner of the street, we were rough and ready guys,
but oh, how we could harmonize. Heart of my heart, met friends were dearer then. Two that we had too far.
I know a tear would glisten if once more I could listen
to that gang that sang Heart of My Heart.
Oh, I love this. Can we do it once again?
Heart of my heart, met friends were dearer then. Two that we had to part.
I know a tear would glisten if once more I could listen
to that gang that sang Heart of My Heart.
Of my heart.
To that gang that sang Heart of My Heart. Out of my heart.
That's real good, fellas. Wonderful. Yeah, I got a jar out of that. What do you say you come back again next week and we sort of pick up where we left off here?
Well, it's certainly nice of you to invite us, Bing, and naturally, we're very glad to accept.
Good. We'll see you next week, then. What's your problem now, Ken?
Well, no problem, Bing. I just like to say I thought you of the four aces were very good. Splendid, I might say.
Well, what else can we say but thanks?
Well, you could join me in saying a few words relative to our weekly skull practice.
I'm ready, boy. Musket's oiled, powder's dry. You may fire when you're ready, Gridley.
Then why are you flaunting that surrender flag?
That is my shirt tail.
Oh, that's what it is. I noticed that. It's hanging out.
It's supposed to. This stylish serape is an inner and outer.
Have it your way.
It's also convenient for the man who dresses in a hurry and puts his pants on first.
I know, but let's get on with our lecture.
That's what I'm telling you. I'm ready.
Where are your notes?
On my shirt tail. Where are yours?
On this tablecloth in the brown derby.
You snob, you restaurant doctor. What do your scribblings say, Ken?
Let me see here. Oh, yes. It says that we're going to discuss the difference between the American economic system and other systems.
Well, that's as easy as that smudge of Cobb salad under your first notation. In our system, we do largely as we please, so long as we behave ourselves and we don't steal tablecloths.
I'm merely borrowed.
While the citizens of some other systems are told what to do in every last detail.
Now look what you've done, Bing.
What's this?
In one rambling sentence, you've almost used up your whole shirt tail and most of our subject material.
Oh, don't fret, son. I've got yards and yards left here.
Good, good. Well, then let's take your opening paragraph and, parse it. Throw stones at the generalities and set up a few specifics in their stead.
I'm game.
Let's take it from the standpoint of a man's livelihood, his work.
Good place to start, and it's about time, too.
In other systems, a man's work, his type of job, is often decided for him, perhaps because of his family background or his political affiliation, or just a bureaucratic whim. The government can tell him when to work and where to work. For instance, he might suddenly be ordered to move from Los Angeles and report to the pickle works at Bedcork, Nebraska, and he'd have to go.
Oh, under that system, I fear me the groaner would end up in the poorhouse, huh?
Well, could be, Bing, but you'd be owning it.
Your confidence in me is very stimulating, Ken, but I'm not so sanguine over the possibility. The way I hear it, in some of these systems, they won't let you own anything, not even a poorhouse. Going into business for yourself is fraught with difficulties, and they cover you with red tape, and it's restricted to certain channels. Most of the citizenry works for the state or else, and even the radio is state-owned.
That's true. The singers sing for the state.
Doesn't that conjure up a frightening picture, Ooh. Ken? Crosby rendering collectivist solos in the lunchroom of a salmon cannery, while fillet cutters continue sipping their soup.
And getting collective indigestion.
If I do good, they throw me a fish. Hit me with a haddock. Fact is, Ken, in these other systems, such things as free and fair competition, the chance to get ahead, the idea of branching out for yourself, gone, out the window. No
Everything
chance.
Leans toward monopoly, and the monopolist is the government itself.
The individual becomes a pawn of the state. Even his personal life is invaded.
It even reaches a point where he can't eat corn on the cob if the government decides he ought to eat rutabagas. Well, it goes even further. Folks are told what they can write about, and even what they can talk about.
And I understand it applies to single as well as married men.
Right. In other words, the individual entrenches himself firmly behind the eight ball. The government becomes the master of the people instead of their servant.
Well, good servant is hard to find these days, even among governments. But, Ken, before all this gets away, before it eludes us completely, why don't you just sort of zip it up in a small package, huh?
Well, I'll make the effort.
Bundle, yes.
Okay, other economic systems differ from ours most noticeably in a degree in which they curb the citizen's individual freedoms and regulate his life. The citizen makes fewer decisions and the government makes more and more. Man, instead of becoming freer, becomes a minion of the state.
You're driving well tonight, Ken, really. Straight and true, and about 75 yards, I should judge.
I was using my putter.
Well, let's not putter around anymore. The show must go on. We got a bright song here, we think. A thing called That's What a Rainy Day is For. Heavens, I hope it doesn't rain in Palm Springs. John Scott, quickly.
Right to cuddle up tight and love you, love you, love you tonight. That's what a rainy day is for. The sound of the rain on each window pane says kiss her, kiss her, kiss her again. That's what a rainy day is for. It isn't just to make the pretty flowers grow, 'cause we both know the wetter the season, the better the reason to huddle up tight and cuddle up tight. Love you, love you, love you tonight. That's what a rainy day is for. Just to make the pretty flowers grow, 'cause we both know the wetter the season, the better the reason to huddle up tight and cuddle up tight. Love you, love you, love you tonight. That's what a rainy day is for. That's what a rainy day is for.
Thank you very much. John Scott Trotter and his elegant ensemble, now, ladies and gentlemen, have prepared an exciting arrangement for you of the great Cole Porter classic, Begin the Begin. Or Begin the Begin. John Scott and boys, really very well done. Here's a lovely ballad. It's something of a standard now. You go to my head. Gee, I hope those Saturday Evening Post articles don't go to Hope's head, but after all, where else could they go? Hot air ascends, they tell me. This is the principle. Mr. Trotter, would you support me in this rendition?
Haunting refrain, and I find you running round in my brain like the bubbles in a glass of champagne. You go to my head like a sip of sparkling burgundy brew, and I find the very mention of you like the kicker in a julep or two. The thrill of the thought that you might give a thought to my plea casts a spell over me till I say to myself, get a hold of yourself, can't you see that it never can be? You go to my head with that smile that makes my temperature rise like a summer with a thousand Julys. You intoxicate my soul with your eyes, though I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. You go my head, though I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. You go to my head. You go to my head.
Well, that just about wraps it up for tonight, friends, but we hope to see you all again next week, the same time, the same place, when our guests will again be the Four Aces. Until then, good night and thank you very much.
This program was produced and transcribed in Hollywood by Bill Morrow and Myrtle McKenzie. Tune in next week and hear Bing and his guests, the Four Aces. The Bing Crosby Show is brought to you each week by the people of General Electric, who believe there is no limit to progress when people work together. Folks, remember that your regular donations to the Red Cross Blood Bank are used to help your community, your neighbors, your family in times of emergency and disaster. No drugs, no substitutes can take the place of the blood you alone can give. Call for your next blood donor appointment at the Red Cross now.